The stories are horrific. Coyotes attacking pets, acting aggressively towards humans. But those stories leave something out, according to a local animal control officer.
He tells Erica Tarantell, coyotes are good for us if we know how to deal with them.
I just can't get it out of my mind to stand on the stairs and see that animal taking my dog.
He was at the bottom of the hill and they tore him apart.
We hear the stories in the news, coyotes attacking dogs, acting aggressively towards humans.
Wasn't frightened at all, walking towards me at all.
The truth about these animals may come as a surprise.
Many people see coyotes as a potential threat, something to be afraid of, when in reality, there's little risk of being harmed by a coyote, and we're all neighbors, so we need to learn to coexist.
If you look at statistics, since their arrival here in Massachusetts, we've had 7 bites, and 3 of those are attributed to rabies. Statistically, you're far better chance of getting bit by a dog on any day of the week than a coyote. So they're very misunderstood, and there are a lot of fears out there that just aren't justified at all.
John Magaronis is the animal control officer for the town of Belmont and representative for the Project Coyote, a national organization seeking to change negative attitudes about coyotes. He says anyone living in Massachusetts lives in coyote territory.
We're trying to educate people on coexisting with coyotes. We understand that these animals are not going away and they're good to have around. So having a top predator around is a good thing. It's a good thing for our ecology and they fill in a good niche. And so we should try to learn to respect that.
Coyotes are opportunistic feeders, he says, eating primarily rodents and smaller animals.
As we pulled up here, I noticed chipmunks all over the place. So that's gonna draw them in as well. And you know, they're just looking for food like all animals do. So if you have cats, for example, if you let your cats out roaming, they could possibly just fall into the food chain. Small dogs are always can be an issue.
Magaronis wants to educate people about keeping their pets safe.
People need to learn that these guys are around, and if they let their little dog out in the backyard, that they need to be out there with them. And there's, you know, a few things you can do. If it's at night, you can open the door and say, hey, coyote, I'm letting my dog out. And see, that puts your voice out there. And since they're usually afraid of people, they may just say, uh-oh, let's, you know, go this way.
But usually it's the people afraid of coyotes. Dog owner Stacy Robbins worries about her Bichon poodle.
My concerns and my fears are that when Buddy's out, one will come and attack him. A year and a half ago, actually a dog that I knew, the family let the dog in the backyard, and the dog was attacked and killed by a coyote.
In talking to you and understanding your fears, a couple things you should know. A dog that's within 4 or 5 feet of you, a coyote's probably not ever gonna come approach you because he sees you. If you do see a coyote and you're walking your dog, small little dog, I always recommend you pick them up. Hold them tight. If you have a jacket on, maybe tuck them in your jacket. And just watch the coyote, see what he's gonna do. If he starts approaching you, I recommend, you know, either approach him for a couple of steps and see what happens, or just slowly walk away.
Some coyotes are accustomed to being around people, so they're not afraid. That's when you have to haze them, as Magaronis puts it. Start by looking the coyote in the eyes and taking a couple of steps towards the animal.
If you get out there and you start walking towards him, he's definitely going to get up and run. But you're not done, and he's going to turn around and reevaluate. And that's when he turns around, he's got to see you coming at him again. And then that'll definitely get his attention and he should take off completely. I also recommend people just stand there, put their hands on their hips, kind of look around like you're a predator.
Hazing coyotes and reminding them that we're the top predator is the first step, says Magaronis, to living together peacefully.
And that way they can be in our cities and towns, they can go out there and clean up the rodents and the rats and all that stuff, and yet give us a healthy space so we don't have any problems with them.
And it is pup season, so coyote pups are out of their den, and people should know this because they will be traveling with their parents.
Right, and the parents will be protective, obviously, mm-hmm. at this time of year. So if you get a little bit close, they may start to posture in sort of an aggressive and threatening way. It's telling you you're getting too close, back off a little bit, which is what you should do. Especially if you have a dog with you, you might want to make sure it's on a leash. or put it up in your arms if it's a small dog and then just slowly back away, or use some of the other methods that he just described. They generally will not attack. It's just a posture, but it's letting you know, hey, back off.
Back off. All right. A frightening creature is rising from the garden, the giant hogweed.